Hey guys, so today I'm going installing the master brake pump. So here's the tools that needed. I have wrenches and screwdriver, pliers, cable ties, syringe, and a transparent hose, and brake fluid, some paper towels, and rag. So firstly, I will remove the old brake fluid. So open the cap. And then use a syringe to suck all the brake fluid out. See how dirty is it, and then get your wrenches on there and put the hose on it. And then the other end is connected to the bottle. So now I just gonna pump the master brake pump few times and crack it open. Pump, get the old fluid out. So you can see the fluid is coming out. So when there are not much fluid coming up, I will top the reservoir with new brake oil. Before putting the new oil, I should clean it up with some paper towels. Oh, that stuff is nasty. So clean it up with some rag or paper towel. So you clean it as clean as possible. Then top it off with some new brake fluid to flush it. So get the new fluid in. Not too full, because we gotta change the brake pump, so it's not useful. So we just need to flush the old brake fluid on the brake hose and caliper. So now we continue pumping it. So we close it and pump a few times. We release it and close and pump until the fluid come out from the nipples. So here comes the brake fluid. So continue pumping. So I will continue the video when I finish pumping it. So here is the final result. Now the fluid is very clear, so we can move to the next step. As you can see, it's very clear. And we continue pumping it. Yeah. So now we can move to the next step. So the next step is remove the old master brake pump. On the mat S is a 8mm bolt. So it's it. And I have a mixed mesh hex bolt. It's rust. There's some rust on it. So stick it in and get a few taps. And crack it. Yeah. Lucky I can get it off without any problem. So next is to release the banjo bolt from the master brake pump, which is here. Release the banjo bolt, which is this. It's a 12mm bolt. So now you need to get some paper towels to catch the brake fluid. And now we can fully remove the master brake pump. So you can get some paper towels and stick it inside so it will not stop dripping. It will stop dripping. Not to forget to remove the brake switch wire. Here is the old pump, and now we got to install the new pump. Here is the master brake pump, new one. So we will install these two screws. And install it. So we now just loosely install it. So later I will adjust the placement for it. Just roughly screw it on. So now I'm gonna get the reservoir. So I'm going to plan where to mount it. So here is the reservoir and the bracket. So now I'm gonna test where to mount it. So for the reservoir, it comes with this bolt. So you unscrew it, and it has a rubber to prevent cracking when it's vibrating. So you install rubber, then screw, and then washer. Lastly is the bracket. So install screwing, so you can tighten it. So on the Mat S, it doesn't have any place to install it. So maybe I will be creative to find a place to install this. Maybe it will be something like that. So finally, I decided to mount it like this. So later, I will make a L bracket to connect this to this. So it will be nicer, not too far from the master brake pump. Later, I will make that. So now we're gonna bleed the brake first. So we need to install the banjo bolt on the aftermarket master brake pump. The banjo bolt is connected to here. So I'm gonna replace this banjo bolt with a brake sensor, because the master brake pump did not come with a brake switch. So I bought this hydraulic pressure brake sensor. So we're gonna install it with the hydraulic hose, brake hose. So oh, and don't forget the seals. So this is the two seals or washer. So one on the top of the banjo bolt, and one is on the below of the banjo bolt. So it will be something like this, and the banjo bolt, and another washers. The original brake hose is not long enough, so I just install it temporarily. I will not be riding this bike, and I will get a new brake hose that's called blank. So just install this temporarily. And the wire, later I will cut it to length. So for now, I just slip it inside, then test for the brake light, is it working or not. If working, I will shorten the wires and connect it properly. So for now, it's just like that. So now we can put some brake fluid on the reservoir and start bleeding it. So for the bleeding process, you will need to remove the cap and put some brake fluid inside the reservoir. don't put the fluid too full, so place the cap back on it because it maybe will squirt out. So now we gotta start to pump it. So pump until there's a bit pressure, then we gotta bleed it from the brake caliper. So pump until there are a little bit pressure. So continue pumping. Pump. And also make sure the bleeding screw on the brake caliper is tight. If not, it will come out from here. So we continue pump. And after that, we will move on to the brake caliper side. So put in the wrenches and put on the clear hose to the caliper nipple. And pump the master brake pump few times and release the bolt while holding the lever. And release when you tighten the bleeding valve. So pump a few times. Pump. Hold, open, and close, and release. And repeat that. When you're doing this, make sure the reservoir is full of brake fluid. If not, you will suck the air in, so you need to repeat it again. So let's continue pumping. So pump. Hold, release, and tighten, and release the lever and pump. Release and tighten and release the brake.
One eternity later.
So I think this is the best that I could do. So we have some squeaking sound. I think it's because of this rubber is touching the screw. So maybe the sound is come from there. Yeah, this rubber and the screw is touching it. So later I will put a caper tight on here and leave it overnight. So hope it can get better because now it's not very good, but it's good enough. So I will caper tight it later and leave it overnight. And the master brake pump kit also come with a clutch lever. So now I'm gonna install it. So firstly, I have to remove the old clutch lever, and it is 8mm. So remove it. And there's a clutch wire, so remove it also. And we can loosen the bolt all the way. And lastly, I will remove the clutch cable from the old clutch lever. releasing the clutch cable, you need to loosen the what they call this adjustment screw. So loosen it, screw it back in so the cable can be easily come out. So loosen it all the way until you can undo the clutch cable. So with this I will use a screwdriver. So we have a line here, so align it. And maybe I will try to just take it out and slip it out. Here is the old one. So it has a switch here. So now we're gonna install the new one. It also have a switch. So firstly is to install the wire. Like that. So you have a groove here, so you line up. And I got the wire inside, and now we can install back the clutch lever. So first screw, second screw, and lastly is installing the clutch cable wire. Then I think that's all for this installation. So make sure when you're screwing this, it need to be even. If not, it will crack. The bracket will crack. So screw it evenly. And then install the wire.